What's going on, guys? Because we're back with part 3 of Dragon Age Origins, and we are heading out to the Korcari Wilds to work on our quest, Tainted Blood, and the Grey Warden's cache here before the battle at Ostagar.
Hail! I'm told you all have business in the wilds. The gate's open for you. Just be careful out there. Even a Grey Warden won't be safe in the forest tonight.
Yes, sir. Alright, so we are now in the Korcari Wilds. We got our boys with us. So we got Davith here, who is a rogue archer. Kind of got points in archer. He's got some dual weapon too. He's actually whatever. And then we got Jory here, who is a two-hand warrior. And we got Jory as, they got him under custom, we'll just put him as a scrapper. And aggressive, I guess, we'll put Davith as, should we keep him back? Let's do him as an archer, ranged. And then Alistair is going to be like a defender, aggressive, and then we're going to be us. He's got a bow on, so sounds fine to me. Let's get rid of this stuff. Okay, Korcari Wilds, let's do it. We gotta find Darkspawn Blood, but first we gotta fight these wolves. Nice.
On it.
I swear, anytime I have a two-handed guy in my group, it always seems like they just take so much damage. Like, Jory's gonna be taking tons of damage all the time here. Health fruit. Is he gaining health? He is. You know what? I think it might be a little different on hard. I've never played hard before, so. Let's see. A more aggressive enemy AI. You need to make sophisticated use of tactical pausing as well as clever combinations. Spells of talents. Friendly fire is no longer scaled down. That could be dangerous for me. And your party will not heal as easily. Enemies will inflict more damage, be encumbered by status effects for shorter durations, and demonstrate good resistance to various damage types. Oh boy, this is going to be a bad idea to play this on hard, I think. Let's see how we do. I'm really not feeling good about it. There's our dying soldier. Actually, let's go back around first. Because I think we can find the corpse of, Missionary Jogby over here. First, who has a letter which leads to a quest called the Missionary, which we found a corpse, a letter path through the wilds that should lead to a place where the deceased is meant to meet his father. Consult the note for more information. Actually, I guess we should probably do that. I'm trying to remember the note. It's under the quest related, I would assume. Letter to Jogby. Look for a tree leaning ruin. Look between a high ruin arch and mosses. Walk along the path, roots, and stones up to our chest. Okay, I know where that's at.
Over here. Who is that? Grey Wardens?
Well, he's not half as dead as he looks, is he?
My scouting band was attacked by Darkspawn. They came out of the ground. Please help me. I've got to return to camp.
Let's bandage him up at least.
I have bandages in my pack.
Thank you. I've got to get out of here.
Did you hear? An entire patrol of seasoned men killed by Darkspawn.
Calm down, Sir Jory. We'll be fine if we're careful.
Those soldiers were careful, and they were still overwhelmed. How many Darkspawn can the four of us slay? A dozen? A hundred? There's an entire army in these forests.
There are Darkspawn about, but we're in no danger of walking into the bulk of the Horde.
How do you know? I'm not a coward, but this is foolish and reckless. We should go back.
Overcoming these dangers is part of our test, dude.
That's true.
Know this. All Grey Wardens can sense Darkspawn. Whatever their cunning, I guarantee they won't take us by surprise. That's why I'm here.
You see, Sir Knight, we might die, but we'll be warned about it first.
That is reassuring.
That doesn't mean I'm here to make this easy, however. So let's get a move on.
We don't get Dog with us. I guess Dog is an actual party member. So yeah, he's still with, you can only have four party members. You can go as a ranger class, a ranger specialization, to bring out another animal with you, so that's pretty cool.
That flower, white with a red center. The kennel master Ostagar was asking about those.
Oh, okay. So maybe we can do this quest. Why did you want them?
The kennel master said this flower can help dogs that get sick from biting Darkspawn. At any rate, he was offering a reward if someone went into the wilds and brought him one. Might want to think about it, is all.
Sounds good, alright. So we can still do that quest, it's just a different. If you don't have Dog with you already, then they actually have it where you have to collar him and be nice. Like, you have to go in his cage and put a, not a collar, but a... like a mouth thing, whatever you call it, on him, and then he kind of likes you, and the guy says, oh, he likes you. But since you have him, you just have to do the quest in this fashion, it sounds like. Damn. Vial of Darkspawn Blood. We need three of those, I think, for our actual quest itself. Which we get pretty, very easily out here. There's also a Death Root up here, which is used in poison making. Something that we could mess with eventually. And there's an Elf Fruit way over there. Save. I know there's a camp over here that has a lot of guys, if I remember correctly. That could actually be a little tough. And since I'm playing on hard, I'm not really sure what to expect for most of these fights if they're like really crazy hard. We don't have any mages or any way to really stop stuff right now, so we're kind of just going hardcore here and just seeing what we can do.
Let's make this quick, Joey. On your guard.
See if Davith can take out the archers. Use a pinion shot on him. I don't know if that really does anything specific damage wise.
It's either you or me.
Yeah, see, freaking Jory's dying again.
It's gonna be me.
Big time. Holy cow, he's dying. We should probably give these guys some health potions. I don't want them dying. But he's like completely surrounded by dudes, getting his butt kicked. Oh, he's stunned too. Oh, he got it on, but he's still hurting. Shield wall. Right now we don't really need this, right? Because it reduces damage. Actually, we don't need anything on right now. Let's just go with it. We're not really tanking. But we're doing kind of gotta, you know, put those things on. There, our quest is updated. We got enough of the vials of blood. I think we'll still get more.
On it.
Yeah. What I would like to do is try to do it in the way that, you know, I use these in the proper times. Like right now. Like, since this gives us a bonus to our armor, which is our damage resistance, if like a guy who's going to hit you hard, put that one on. This is more for more accurate guys. Maybe if you're grouped up against in a way, because that'll make you dodge more and all that kind of stuff. That's what I'm kind of hoping for. If I can remember to do that stuff positive or in the right way. So we got a small shield, a mud idol for cold resistance, and Rigby's Field Journal, which... Signs of the Chastened questline comes from, which is a little quest coming through this area where we have to hit markers. Actually, let me look at Alistair's stuff. Yeah. Shagarland sword is definitely better for him. And this ash thing is definitely not better for him, and those aren't better for him either. Okay, so the signs, they're a chasing trail sign here. We gotta start clicking on these. There's about five, six of them.
On it.
That you need to find, and if you find them in the right ones, you get something at the end of it. There's one up there. Once you click that first one, this one shows up.
Looky here.
Okay. Now we head back this way, and we'll find some more coming down this path, plus some darkspawn, I remember, are going to jump out at us. But if we get close to some of them. Some darkspawn up there. Let's get this elf root. Acid flasks, acid flasks, acid flasks. Those are things that I never use. I never, ever, ever use items like that. Maybe I should start using those. Maybe more useful in this game. Of course, I can't use it because you need poison making. When thrown, it splashes acid. I can't even throw something without having poison making. I can't even pick up something and toss it. Does anybody have poison making here? Davith's got it. So let's put some acid flask stuff on Davith here. Along with some lesser health in case he gets damaged. And we can try to remember to use that, even though he probably won't. To be totally honest. More chastened. Chastened? I think it's chastened. They say it enough in the game, but I can never remember. We can hear the darkspawn. If they're underground, they pop up when you get close, I think. Yep. The rogues. Got a level. Alright, got that other one. Let's head on down. There's another one of the flowers. If we didn't get the one earlier, I think we would be able to get that there for the dog, for the quest for the Mabari Hounds. Quest is another chastened sign. Okay. And this is where the dead body we found with a note to the sun is. If we can remember, let's hold position. Because we can, I think we can keep it where they're not all gonna come. And if Davith could actually hit something, it'd be nice. Try to play a little more strategically here. Is that the big dog? Come on. He can't hit the side of a barn. Broadside of a barn, man. I forgot I leveled. Jeez. Okay, so cunning's fine for now, I think. Gotta start thinking about what it is I'm gonna want to do next. Like, I know I'm gonna need dexed. Let's just see if we put strength in. Like, I'm gonna start worrying about. I need 20 dex for shield tactics, which I definitely want because it does not. It stops flanking strikes from hitting. I need 16 dex for shield cover alone. Well, this actually helps too, but I kind of want to work on my taunt stuff a little bit. At least threaten first. Threaten is like, I think, just your basic taunt. It helps people to go after you first. And then once they leave, you can taunt a large area and bring them back towards you. So if we get threatened to start with here, that's kind of the way I want to go with this, at least now. So we'll keep threaten on. And that's just a sustained ability, that upkeep of 35 fatigue. We lose a little bit of fatigue for having it on. But that is kind of, you know, that should draw the, you know, draw to me creatures.
Here we go!
Nice, Alistair. The Elf Wolf doesn't drop anything. It's crazy. So here we found that message with the dead body floating in the water about how he left something for his son between two statues. This is that chest. And we get a chasen flat blade. Good for a two-hander. Wooden kite shield. Not a terrible shield, but not that great. And a letter. Farewell letter. And that's just a letter to her son, and the quest is actually completed, so that's done. So let's take a look at some of the stuff here. We got the chasen flat blade. Gives a little bit more attack, melee crit, and armor penetration, so that's definitely it. And the wooden kite shield, I don't think is actually worth a damn. For it's the exact same thing he's got. But his is a Templar shield, so it looks cooler, and it's definitely not as good as the Shield of High Ever. I quick save a lot. There's a couple of reasons, too. I do it anyway. out of habit. And then I also do it because this game does tend to have, at least on newer systems, and I was having a little bit of problems at times, and I looked it up, and it seems like it's kind of a thing on the newer operating systems, Windows 7 and above, and I'm running 8.1, where there's a possibility of the game freezing on you, so, or crashing. So we've got an elf root here. We were up there earlier. We kind of went around. We could have went right under here. Actually, I think if you go under here, they say a little something about these bodies. Or Alistair does.
Look there.
Yeah.
Poor slobs. That just seems so excessive.
And there's Darkspawn up there. We're going to come around the other side, I think. There's a chest up there. There's another chasing trail sign up there. There's a lot of Darkspawn in that area, though. So let's swing around. I don't know what's the better way to attack that, actually. I don't know if we go this way, if we get grouped up, or what. I guess we'll find out. There's another. You hear the Darkspawn. There they are.
A little frantic. I can see why.
All right. Let's go.
Fear is your
that.
So in all honesty, if anybody's watching this who knows how threaten works, let me know, because does it mean they're just going to come toward me anyway? I think it just raises my threat number, basically. Or is it only really working on the guy I'm hitting? Because it says each melee attack. I know how taunt works. It's a AoE, bring them back toward you. I think they're both pretty much necessary for a good tank, though. So we got wolves and Hurlocks. Those guys aren't coming. That guy's red, but he's not coming. Missionary Rigby's last testament.
On it.
So he's a rogue, but he still can't open chests, so he's not a very good rogue. So that, what we got, basically, you get a letter from this missionary about a cache that he has hidden, and it's back kind of where we almost, one of the first fights we did, we have to run back over there and check it out in a few here. Lesser health potions, we need those. Malachite, okay. So we're gonna hit this stuff up here, and then we'll head back over to that and get that thing. It's a quest related thing. Quartz, and I don't think he's good enough to open this chest. No. It's a piece of crap. Rogue, I'll tell you that much. I don't know why the Grey Wardens would want him. Can't do shit.
This should be easy enough.
And this should be a chasing sign up here.
As you wish.
Yep, okay. Says quick save. I couldn't quick save between those two fights because that the enemies over here were close enough to have that red circle that the game still thought I was in a fight, even though they weren't actually running toward me. So here's this. We need to run back where we came, kind of the beginning over where that first camp with a whole bunch of darkspawn. Which is kind of out in this general direction. when we first got the chase and trail signs, there was a campfire, and that's where his loot is, and it should pop up now. Yeah, the hidden cache there. So we can pick this up, we can open it. I don't think there's anything that great in it, or we can do the quest and bring it to Jeddah, which is what he wanted. So let's do that. And she, I believe, is at Redcliffe, maybe? Or Denerim. One of the two. In Redcliffe. The last wish was that she would get that, so. I believe she's in the Chantry at Denerim, at Redcliffe. And you just give it to her. I don't know if you get anything for it. Maybe a little bit of XP, maybe. I don't think you get any specific items back or anything like that, or money, though. I think I've opened it before. I don't think there's anything in there that's like definitely worth not just doing the quest. I kind of like to just do quests anyway, so that's what I'm going to do. They really need a toggle. I wish there's a toggle to keep this stuff up at all times, because you got to kind of hold tab while you run.
Right.
You know, not that it's a huge deal, but it would help my fingers a little bit, because I like to keep the stuff up so I don't miss things. Autosave. That's, oh, I remember this now. There's going to be a tough little fight here. Definitely a tough fight. I think we can get in a fight before we even get to that guy. Keep clicking this to hold position so they don't run on their own. Because if they see him, they may just run after him. I kind of want to try to get this sign on my own first. See, he doesn't really take off, I don't think, until you get in that area. The thing about this is that there's a lot of traps over here. Killing this guy without a mage to hold him up or something is kind of tough, from what I remember. Without him getting back there. Once he gets back there, he kind of... Yeah, does his own thing. We can maybe be able to hit him with a pinion shot. Which he didn't, which he resisted.
You'll never know what hit him.
Alright. So they're gonna run over there. The problem is they're gonna run into these damn traps like morons. I think he may see the traps.
On it.
They're not really fighting. Oh, he's throwing shit.
On it.
Yeah, this is definitely not working out. So. For that mage.
Yep.
Oof, that was close.
That was most painful. I will need bandaging.
That was close, my friends. That was close. Is this an actual trap here? Yeah, I was already done. I think he'd be able to... Even though I really don't know if he'd be able to disarm those traps. There's the chase and cache. We actually got enough of those signs after that one to... That's where it's at. Once you get them all, you can see that. So up north, this dead body here had a pouch of ashes, which is used for a quest to fight a really difficult enemy up there, which we'll get to in a second. Let's head over here and get this Chazen cache though, because I think there's some decent loot in here. We're gonna get jumped here as well. Yeah. Another one of those flowers for the dog here. I'm assuming if you didn't get one earlier, maybe you can get that one.
As you wish.
Okay, so this has some decent shit in it. A mace with the strength, a nice two-hander, gives a bonus less to attack though, but a lot of damage. A bow, helmet, some robes. Some decent stuff. We don't even have a helmet on. Gives us 3 defense bonus to put that on. Nothing here I don't think is going to help Alistair out. No. The bow could help out Davith, though. The Wild's bow? Yeah, more nature resistance. Actually, less damage, though. It actually just gives you the nature resistance, that's about it. Nothing really that great. And Jory's, the Crusher is actually not as good as the Chazen Flat Blade at all, really. Well, the minus attack kinda sucks. So for the most part, it's decent stuff that we'll sell. Oh, I forgot this Mud Idol. I don't know if it's even 10% cold resistance. I guess I'll throw it on. The stuff to sell though would be nice. We do want to get that other backpack when we get back to town, or get back to the fortress. Alright, so we're done here. So now, one of the tougher fights, probably the toughest fight out here, is coming. If we do this side quest, it's a red enemy, which is, just means insanely strong. Up here, so we may die. We don't really have a way to stun besides just the regular shield bashes and everything. Don't we? Alistair's got shield covers activated normally. Shield bash, shield pommel, yeah. So. Okay, let's save and throw this stuff up on here. So, sprinkle the ashes on the stones basically brings forth a very difficult demon. Gazarath.
This should be easy.
Summons Gazarath.
Look at this mess. I love it. Come now. Defend yourself.
You don't say I didn't warn you.
All right.
May our blade strike true.
Stay still.
See, I got threatened on, but he is not even trying to. He's not on me at all. He's on Jory. Probably because he's doing mighty blows and he's beating the shit out of him in those ways. Ooh, Jory's about to get his ass whooped there. Nice shot. I think Davith ended up killing him on that shot. So there's a shade, a demon. Should get chainmail out of that. And Enchanter's Footing, which is a mage only. Shoes gives 6 defense, which is pretty good for a mage, I guess. The chainmail, 510, definitely not better than what I got going. How about you? Exact same thing as you got. How about you, Jory? Same thing as you got, so. If you're a mage, that's a good fight to get those boots. They don't give any bonus to magic or anything, but they give bonus to defense. So. Actually, I'd like Jory to heal up a little bit, because this is basically the last fight in the Korcari Wilds. There's about 5 or 6 dudes here, one yellow enemy, which means he's tough. So let's pause for a minute. And let him heal up a little bit. Okay. Because I know once we get up to this elf root, I think they'll see us. Yeah. We could just kind of have Dabth pop some shots, maybe, see if he can take this first guy out. There's no reason to, you know, once you run up there, we're gonna get surrounded by dudes. Take out the scout first. I'm gonna go, Dabth. Weapons at the ready. And I think a lot of the game on these harder level, difficulty level, a little, you know, it's gonna be about positioning. This game is a lot about positioning and stuff like that, like making sure. That, see, there's no reason to bring all these guys to us at one time when we can bring one guy. Dabth is taking damage, but I normally just run up there, you know, but I'm gonna try to play more intelligently here on this playthrough, take my time, make use of the hold positions, and try to keep everybody, you know, a little more alive, I guess. I mean, the range of the archers are so insanely long that there's no reason to not pull. Enchanted dagger, nice. Fire bolt, fire arrows, and a little bit of cash for the group. And we got a herlock here, and that's it. Yeah, that was easy. A little bit of range attacks to soften up a few dudes. Just pull as little as we can at a time, and it all works out in the end. All right. So here's what we got to get to. Here's where our papers are, the Warden cache.
Well, well. What have we here? Are you a vulture, I wonder? A scavenger, poking amidst a corpse whose bones were long since cleaned? Or merely an intruder, come into these darkspawn-filled wilds of mine in search of easy prey. What say you, Scavenger or intruder?
Okay, neither. The Grey Wardens once owned this tower.
Is a tower no longer? The wilds have obviously claimed this desiccated corpse. I have watched your progress for some time. Where do they go, I wondered? Why are they here? And now you disturb ashes none have touched for so long. Why is that?
Don't answer her. She looks chastened, and that means others may be nearby.
Oh, you fear barbarians will swoop down upon you.
Yes, swooping is bad.
She's a witch of the wild, she is. She'll turn us into toads.
Witch of the wilds. Such idle fancies, those legends. Have you no minds of your own? You there, handsome lad. Tell me your name and I shall tell you mine. Let us be civilized.
You can call me Scales. Ooh, I am Scales. A pleasure to meet you.
Now that is a proper civil greeting, even here in the wilds. You may call me Morrigan. Shall I guess your purpose? You sought something in that chest? Something that is here no longer?
Here no longer? You stole them, didn't you? You're some kind of sneaky witch thief.
How very eloquent. How does one steal from dead men?
Quite easily, it seems. Those documents are Grey Warden property, and I suggest you return them.
I will not, for 'twas not I who removed them. Invoke a name that means nothing here any longer if you wish. I am not threatened.
Who removed them?
'Twas my mother, in fact.
Okay, can you take us to her?
There is a sensible request. I like you.
I'd be careful. First it's, I like you, but then zap, frog time.
She'll put us all in the pot, she will. Just you watch.
If the pot's warmer than this forest, it'd be a nice change.
Follow me then, if it pleases you.
Morrigan, she's pretty awesome. Got a great voice. Whoever did the voice, it's just awesome.
Greetings, Mother. I bring before you four Grey Wardens who...
I see them, girl. Much as I expected.
Are we supposed to believe you were expecting us?
You are required to do nothing, least of all believe. Shut one's eyes tight or open one's arms wide. Either way, one's a fool.
She's a witch, I tell you. We shouldn't be talking to her.
Quiet, Dareth. If she's really a witch, do you want to make her mad?
There is a smart lad. Sadly irrelevant to the larger scheme of things. But it is not I who decides. Believe what you will. And what of you? Do you possess a different viewpoint? Or do you believe as the others do?
Let's see. I believe you have something we need.
They did not come to listen to your wild tales, Mother.
True. They came for their treaties, yes? And before you begin barking, your precious seal wore off long ago. I have protected these.
You... Oh, you protected them.
And why not? Take them to your Grey Wardens and tell them this blight's threat is greater than they realize.
Okay, thanks for returning them.
Such manners. Always in the last place you look. Stockings. Oh, do not mind me. You have what you came for.
Time for you to go, then.
Do not be ridiculous, girl. These are your guests.
Oh, very well. I will show you out of the woods. Follow me.
All right, so we meet Morrigan, we meet Flemeth, who is a pretty important character as well. And we are back at Ostagar with everything that we needed to do. So we are going to stop here and continue later with Ostagar at night. And a lot of stuff's going to happen here really soon. So thanks for watching, everybody. See you later.